फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अवर यूट्यूब चैनल बाय ज्ञान मंजरी मॉडर्न स्कूल। टुडे इज अवर सब्जेक्ट इज साइंस फॉर स्टैंडर्ड 9th। इन दिस सब्जेक्ट वी हैव स्टार्टेड द चैप्टर नंबर 6, टिश्यूज, एंड अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ टिश्यूज वी हैव लर्न। व्हाट आर टिश्यूज, टाइप्स ऑफ टिश्यूज? देर आर टू मेन टाइप ऑफ टिश्यूज, एनिमल टिश्यूज एंड प्लांट टिश्यूज। इन प्लांट टिश्यूज देर आर टू मेन टाइप्स, they are meristematic tissue and permanent tissues. The types of meristematic tissues are 3, apical, intercalary and lateral meristem. Also the types of permanent tissue are simple permanent and complex permanent. In simple permanent, sclerenchyma, collenchyma and parenchyma, and in complex permanent, xylem and phloem. Xylem are responsible for upward transportation of water and minerals from the root, and phloems are responsible for conduction of food material which prepared by the leaves of a plant. So all these we have discussed in previous periods. Also students, we have started with animal tissues. There are 4 main types of animal tissues. They are epithelial tissues, connective tissues, nerve tissue and muscle tissues. Okay, out of these 4 types, the 2 types, epithelial tissue and connective tissues, we have discussed the characteristics of these 2 type of animal tissues, epithelial and connective. Which are the types of epithelial tissues? Mainly simple squamous epithelium, columnar epithelium and cuboidal epithelium. And in connective tissues, mainly there are 7 types. Also where they are located in your body, that we have discussed students. Areolar tissues, adipose tissues, blood, bone, cartilage, ligament, tendon, and for what they are responsible, the joint, which organs they are joining in our, means in plant, animal body. So all these we have discussed. Now only 2 types of animal tissues are left, and they are muscle tissue and nerve tissue. Then we will finish with this chapter. Okay students, we are studying here in a classification wise, so it will be easy for you to understand which are the types of tissues and also the characteristic of tissues. Again and again try to remember the types of tissues. Okay, now nerve tissues. Nerve tissues means, from the name we come to know, they are connected with our brain, nerves. They are responsible for transport of the message from any organ of the body to the brain, also the spinal cord. And again, some nerve tissues, they take the message from brain to the organ of the body, means to and fro. They take the message to the brain and from the brain to the organ of the body. So here we can say nerve tissue, reception and conduction of sensation, students. They are joining the brain, spinal cord in constitution of nerves. Now, reception, conduction of sensation. What is the meaning of this? Students, we will learn about nerve tissue first and then we will learn about the muscle tissue. In your textbook, about the muscle tissue is given on the page number 77, and about the nerve tissue and the figure is given on, some part is given on 78 page number. But here we will learn about nerve tissue first and then we will learn about the muscle tissue. Okay, so now come back to the nerve tissue. Here the point is sensation. Suppose student, accidentally we touch any hot plate, what will happen? So in our hand there are nerve tissues. These nerve tissues immediately take the message to the spinal cord, and spinal cord interpret this information, and again it gives the order to nerve cell. Different type of nerve cell, they are called motor nerves, and according to that we immediately withdraw our hand from that hot plate. Students, this action is done in a fraction of a second. As we touch the hot plate, immediately we withdraw our hand. Meanwhile, the message has gone to the spinal cord, interpretation is done by spinal cord, and again the order is given by spinal cord. It gives the order to particular organ where the sensation is there, and again the action is taken, students. So it takes very little time to do all this activity. And now this activity, which decisions are taken by spinal cord, are called reflex actions. Means immediately the action is taken. But student, if there is some big problem, if thinking process is there, suppose in exam you are facing a particular example or sum, so at that, to solve that sum, spinal cord can't take the decision. This is the thinking process, and at that time the messages are sent to brain, student. So here brain and spinal cord takes the decision for the reflex action, immediate action. Suppose the sun, intense sun rays is there, so immediately our eyes become small, and in the darkness we open our eyes. Suppose the mosquito bite on our hand, immediately we bit by other hand. So these are called reflex action, immediate actions, and for that no involvement of brain is necessary. Only the spinal cord takes the decision, interprets and give the orders. So here nervous tissue, but these nervous tissues are connected brain, spinal cord, and in constitution of nerves, means the nerves are of two types. Some nerves takes the message to the brain, they are called neurons, and some nerves are take the messages from brain or spinal cord to the organ. They are motor nerves, MOTOR, motor nerves. So here we can say nerve tissues are they are connected with reception and conduction of sensation. Means sensation is conducted to the spinal cord or to the brain by nerve tissue. Special type of tissues in animals are there. Okay? And again, the messages from the brain or spinal cord is sent to the particular organ where the sensation is felt. So these are called, students, nerve tissue. Okay? Just student, note down this much only. Not about this, this will be learn afterwards. Just note down this: nerve tissue, reception and conduction of sensation, brain, spinal cord, and constitution of nerve cell, and types, axon. Means these are the part. I will draw the figure and I will explain it, but just note down this because I am going to rub this. Okay students, now what is the shape of a nerve tissue? When students, we have started with fifth chapter, cell unit, basic unit of life. In that we have drawn this nerve tissue. Again I am explaining this. This is just like this. from here, it is given on your textbook, students. So these are, and again they are divided into branches like this. This figure is given in your textbook, students. Try to draw with me, because in the biology figures are very necessary. Here there is a nucleus. This is a nerve cell having the nucleus. Okay, again here we can say, just like sensation, passage for transformation of sensation is there. This is called nucleus. Then dendrites, these are dendrites. Axon, these are messages are passing through it, are axon. And this is called cell body. Cell body. This is the figure of just one nerve cell. Neuron, it is also called as neuron. So suppose hot plate, this hand, my this finger touch the hot plate, so here the nerve tissues are present, so the sensation is taken by the dendrites which are present in my finger. It is passes to the nucleus, means a cell body. From cell body, this sensation is passes through axon. Here again another nerve cell is there. So from this nerve cell, this sensation are passed to the other nerve cell. Then it passes the sensation to the next nerve cell. In this way, by passing the message, this message is passed to the our spinal cord. Now spinal cord takes the decision by interpreting the messages, the sensation, and immediately takes the decision and it sent to the nerve cell. We draw the hand from there, we draw the finger from that hot plate. So here this nerve cell won't go from these to spinal cord, but just it passes the message from one nerve cell to the next, from next to next. In this way, messages are passed and the order are conducted to the muscle. So in this way, there are nerve tissue. Students, in standard 10th, you will learn in detail about this reflex action, reflex arc, and again about the brain, how it takes a decision, what are the structure of brain, all in detail you will learn in standard 10th. But here just you have to learn about nerve tissue and nerve cell, how the nerve cell are there, what are the parts of a nerve cell, means dendrites, axon, and the cell body and nucleus are the parts. In this way, the messages are passed to the brain and also to the if sometimes some big decision has to be taken, at that time the messages are passed to the brain and brain think over it. Also brain is having the sensation from visual, for auditory, for the taste. And all the receptions, all the sensations are received by brain, and brain interpret it and take the decision. So in detail you will learn in standard 10. This is just about the nerve tissue. You have to learn up to only this now. Okay students, now we will learn about the last type of animal tissues. Okay, and this is muscle tissue. Page number 77, figures are given here. There are mainly three types: striated muscle, smooth muscle and cardiac muscle. Okay, let's see one by one. First of all, stratified or striated, it is also called stratified or striated muscle. What are the characteristics? They are long, cylindrical. Students, figure is given in your textbook. Unbranched, it is not having branch, it is just like a single. Multinucleated means they are having more than one nucleus. When there is a more than one nucleus, it is called multinucleated, and they are responsible for voluntary actions. Now again, question creates, what is voluntary action? The actions which are taken by thinking is called voluntary actions. There is an involvement of brain is there, is called voluntary actions. And if there is a no involvement of brain, it is called involuntary actions. It is done suddenly, reflexly. Okay, but the stratified muscles are long, cylindrical, unbranched, multinucleated. I have written just the points, student. In the exam, in the fair book, in the homework, you have to write in full sentences. These are just the point. You can write stratified muscles are long and cylindrical, they are unbranched and having more than one nucleus, therefore they are called as a multinucleated. They are responsible for the voluntary actions. Figure is given, student, in your textbook, page number 77. A figure is there, nucleus, and only there are so many nucleus, therefore it is called multinucleated. Now number 2, unstratified means smooth muscles. They are long, spindle shaped. It is given, spindle shaped and smooth muscles, spindle shaped and uninucleated. What is the meaning of uninucleated? Means they are having the single nucleus, are called uninucleated, and they are responsible for involuntary actions. Involuntary actions means without involvement of brain, reflex actions, immediate actions. And third type is cardiac muscles. Students, from the name you come to know where are they. Cardiac muscles means they are present in our heart. Long, branched, cylindrical and again uninucleated means it is having only single nucleus. This is multinucleated. So comparative study: multinucleated, uninucleated, uninucleated, and they are responsible for involuntary rhythmic actions throughout the life, because our heart beats throughout the life. So these cardiac muscles are long, branched, cylindrical, uninucleated, responsible for involuntary actions, because our heart beats in when we sleep, when we are in sleep, at that time also it beats. So order is not given to the heart, beat, beat, beat. This type of orders are not given to the heart. So involuntary rhythmic, also it is rhythmic contraction, relaxation is there, and throughout the life it doesn't take rest for a minute also. So these are the types of muscle tissues: stratified, unstratified and cardiac muscle. And these are the characteristics I have written in very point wise. Okay students, so just note down this much is enough. I am giving you 2 minutes to note down all these things. Okay students, I think you have noted it. Now we will solve some questions from your exercise, mainly the question number 10. Which type of tissues are located in which organ? Okay students, easy chapter, just it is enough what we have discussed here. That much only you have to learn and you have to write. Okay, in your fair book write whole exercise on the page number 75, because the questions are there which we have discussed. What are tissues? So what are tissues? Tissues are the group of cell having the similar structure, work together to achieve particular functions. So the questions we have discussed already, that you have to write in your fair book. Students, keep writing in your fair book. We will check it when we meet. Just start learning students, as we have discussed that this is the base of standard 10th. In 10th the topic is in detail, but it is there. Question number 10, name the following. Which tissues? Number 1, A. Tissue that forms the inner lining of our mouth. So they are squamous epithelium tissues. Just note down in your textbook student with pencil. Number 2, tissues that connects muscle to bone, tendons. C, tissues that transports food in plants, phloem. If it is asked that tissues which transport the water, then xylem will be the answer. Tissues that store fat, adipose. Connective tissue with fluid matrix, very easy, blood. And the last one, tissues present in our brain, we have discussed just now, nervous tissue. So students, nothing is hard, everything is easy. Also the last one, complete the table. So we have drawn here table so many times, we have discussed all the types of tissues. Okay students, so nothing is hard. Now just time for homework students. Thank you. Don't explain the neuron means dendrites, cell body, nucleus, axon. And number two, explain the type of muscle tissue. Explain means you have to write the characteristics, long, cylindrical, it may be multinucleated, it may be the uninucleated. Okay, voluntary actions are done by it or involuntary actions are done by it. So you have to do this much in the homework, students. Okay, bye, take care. We will meet in the next video with a new chapter. Here we have finished this chapter. Just note down your homework and the question 10 from your exercise. Okay, students, bye, take care.